I'm Patrick Bailey with whiteboardcoder.com. Today is March 31st, 2015, and I'm going to show you how to use the myDAQ. Now, I got this myDAQ last week to help me with a circuits class I'm taking on Coursera. And what I'm going to show you, I figured out how to use the virtual multimeter and the virtual signal source. So I'm going to go over how to use that and set that up. Okay, before I get too far along, I want to quickly create a shortcut for this Elvis app that the National Instruments gives you. So to do that, go to Computer, C, Program Files, x86. Go down here to National Instruments, and then here is the instrument launcher. And I'm just going to create a shortcut. So I'm going to right click on that, create a shortcut. I'm going to rename this Elvis. And I have this launcher. Okay, stick that on my desktop. So I'll close that out. Okay, so now I open this guy. And then what we have here is all the instruments. So last time, I kind of showed how to use the digital multimeter. So now I actually want to do something more interesting. I want to make generate a signal and then detect it on an oscilloscope. So how to do that, we can go to the function generator. So first, open this function generator. And there's the function generator. Now, we need to do some stuff with this myDAQ. So I've already plugged this guy in. And if you look carefully, you've got all these screws on the top. And so you can unscrew them. And they kind of have like a little pinch thing in there. So it keeps goes up and down. I don't know if you can see that very well. But rather than use bare wires, I've got a bunch of these. So I'm going to connect them up and try to figure this out. So first of all, I did figure out that our signal generator is going to generate stuff off of the A0 or A1. So I'll connect it into this A0 right there. For my signal, clamp it down. Use a black for the ground. Clamp that down. So there's my signal, but I wanted to detect it. Now to detect it, for the oscilloscope, you have a 0 plus, 0 minus, 1 plus, 1 minus. Now here I screwed up a little earlier because I didn't know what the difference between the 0 plus and 0 minus was. So I just assumed if you wanted to detect something, you'd put something in the 0 plus and then use the ground. Well, that's not what you do. What it really wants to do is detect the difference between 0 plus and 0 minus. Now, I learned that by watching another video, so I'm going to put a link up to that guy's video. There's a professor who had a whole video that I went through, and it was really interesting showing how this works. So go view that. But I'm going to put this green one in a 0 positive, clamp it down, didn't do a very good job on that. Let me, so 0 plus. I don't know why they just don't make a nice breadboard connection with this out of the as a default. They do have them you can buy, but that seems a little annoying to me. At least we're starting out. Okay, so there is but now I also want to do the A plus, the 1 plus and the 1 minus. Because I want to analyze the signal coming in to a circuit and then analyze the signal coming out at some point so I can see the effects of the circuit, right? That'll help me to learn. Well, I think it'll help me learn a lot more about these circuits. anchor. So those are all in there more or less. So I'm going to take a breadboard here. And we've got the power. And I've got the, essentially the ground for the signal. So now the signal's going through if I would turn it on. Now, to show you something, as I was fiddling with it, I got an LED here. So we can plug the long end in on the positive, the short on the negative. And then I can go to the signal generator here. Now the signal generator right now, when you start it, has a 1 volt amplitude. But I'm gonna drop that down to 0 just to show you something. And it also has a DC offset, so I can just set power through here. So as I raise this up, it's actually not gonna do anything because I'm not running it. So let's click the run button to actually run it. And my light came on. I turned my amplitude down to 0, so there is no sinusoidal wave going through. All it is just direct DC power. And it's 2.8 volts, so if I lower that, yep, there you go, you see the LED goes off. If I raise it, it goes up. So, but that's just basically turn it into a DC power source. So I'll just make that 0, and I'll turn this guy up. So if I turn it, it's got to roughly 5. Oh. 7. Okay, I turn it up to 7, it comes on. Now, you're not going to notice it blinking because I'm going too fast. So if I actually lower this down to 2, you'll see it starts to blink because we have that sinusoidal wave going on. Okay, enough of that fun. So let me stop this and do something a little more real. What I want to do is to detect this signal. So, well, here's where I have to fiddle with my brain a little bit. If the first one, if I go positive, negative here, if I'm thinking correctly, if I turn that on and analyze that, I should just get the same signal back out, right? Okay, so we'll make this 100 hertz. Make this, give it an amplitude of 5, and run it. Now I'm going to go open the oscilloscope so I can actually detect something. And I'm going to detect, I'm enabled the A1 zeros on, and I'll run it. And there we go. And you can see the frequency is 100 hertz, and the voltage is 5 volts, so there you go, peak to peak. It's looking good. But now I actually want to do something a little different. So I'm going to take the power over here, put a 1 kilo-ohm resistor in, so I got power to power. Put this LED in, and then, let's see, take this back to ground, right? And so that shouldn't affect this signal, because it's detecting the original signal, right? But I don't yet have enough power going through it to actually turn the LED on, so let me up that to 8. Okay, so now I got the LED on, and there's my signal. Let me change this to 5 volts, just so you can see it better. But what I'm detecting is the original signal, so it hasn't changed. But what I wanted to detect now is the change after it goes through the diode. So let me plug that in there maybe. Okay, I'm sure I'm gonna screw this up first. And then, there. Let's try that. Now to detect that guy, I have to enable it. It's trying to figure out the frequency. I don't think I did a good job on that. Okay, so trying to detect the difference between the two. 5 volts, 5 volts. Let me adjust this a little bit. Oh, not good. Oh, let me change this to edge. I saw someone do this, which I think will just take a snapshot. There we go. The exact opposite of what I want, isn't it? Okay, so I must have it in backwards. Ah, that looks a little bit better, right? Okay, so I've got the... Okay, well, you can see how it's plugged in. I'll zoom in on that so you can really see it. Now, in the class I'm taking, they're not doing a sinusoidal wave for one of the... Well, I shouldn't say experiments, but one of the examples she's given, she's doing a triangle wave. So I'll turn it to a triangle wave. And then I will I will lower the amplitude. So we'll drop it down just to 5. And of course we get no light and no signal coming through because it's not high enough. And I'll slowly up that. Oh, that's not right. Okay, I don't have this connected right. Here, I'll show you an example from this class I'm taking. Now, in the class I'm taking, here's a portion of the video. This is what they're getting, which makes sense, where the diode... The signal is not going through the diode until it gets high enough because we have the voltage drop. So I'm not doing something right. What am I not doing right? Okay, well, I'll pause this for a second and then I'll figure it out and start the video again. Okay, I figured it out. So I have the negative 1 just going to essentially ground. And then I kind of reverse this, and I put the resistor on the other side. And then I got the 1 plus going here. And now I get a graph that makes sense. Okay. Or oscilloscope reading, I guess. Now if I go here and I turn it down, I'll turn it way down. You know, these little controls are a bugger. I just get a flat line. Bump it up to probably, 5. We don't have an uptick yet. There we go. It's like 6. Okay, 6. I get a little bump. And 8. You can finally start seeing it. Just bump it all the way to 10. Okay, now you can actually see it. I'll change these to 2 volt and 2 volt. Let's see. Oh, wrong way. There you go. Now you can kind of see it. So the difference between the peak here, and the peak here is the voltage drop over the LED. And now I've got this little LED sheet that came with this guy. And so this is a blue. It looks like the voltage drop over a blue is about 3 to 3.4 volts. Now, if I click on this, cursor on, now I get these little cursors, and I can drag them. So I can drag that to the peak, and then I can drag this one to the peak. And you can see I got 4.92 and 2.24. I do a little calculation there. Let's see, 4.93 minus 2.69. So the voltage drop on this is actually a little less than they said, but okay. So that kind of gets you through the basics of getting a circuit working and doing a little bit, creating a signal source and actually measuring it with the oscilloscope with these tools that myDAQ provides. I'm still learning this stuff myself, so forgive me if I mess something up. And if you know how to do something better on this, tell me, and I'll update and make a new video. But hey, I got a circuit working. I got an LED light lighting. Let me drop this frequency down to 20 hertz. There you go. Now you can probably see it blinking, which means I got to fix this guy. See what auto scale does. It doesn't do anything. Oh, there we go. That looks a little... Oh, 5 volt and 2 volt. Oh, that's why. 5 volt and 5 volt. There we go. Okay. And so now you can see it blinking. It looks right. Let's make them 2 volt. 2 volt. Drop it down to... There we go. So now you can see it blinking. Let me take it down to 5. You can probably see that even better. There we go. And then drop this. There we go. So now you can see it blinking and you can see it detecting. Cool. Well, I still got a lot to learn, but I learned something today.